Before trees, the tallest vegetation was only about waist high. And then something wonderful happened. A plant molecule evolved that was both strong and flexible, a material that could support a lot of weight, yet bend in the wind without breaking. Lignin made trees possible. Now, life could build upward, and this opened a whole new territory, a three-dimensional matrix for communities far above the ground. Earth became the planet of the trees. But lignin had a downside. It was hard to swallow. When nature's demolition crew, the fungi and bacteria, tried to eat anything with lignin in it, they got a really bad case of indigestion. And termites wouldn't evolve for at least another 100 million years. What to do with all those dead trees? It took the fungi and bacteria millions of years to evolve the biochemical means to consume them. Meanwhile, the trees just kept springing up, dying, falling over, and getting buried by the mud that built up over eons. Eventually, there were hundreds of billions of trees entombed in the earth, buried forests all over the earth. What possible harm could come from that? This cliff in Nova Scotia is another kind of calendar. It tells the story of that other world that once flourished right here. And this is the death mask of that 300 million year old tree. It was cast by minerals that replaced the original wood cell by cell. In other words, a fossil. The tree surrendered its organic molecules to the environment long ago. Its carbon and water, only its shape remains. When this tree was alive, it took in carbon dioxide and water and used sunlight to turn them into energy-rich organic matter. The tree gave off oxygen as a waste product. That's what trees and other plants still do. When plants die, they decay, and this reverses the transaction. Their organic matter combines with oxygen and decomposes, putting carbon dioxide back into the air. This balances the books for the chemistry of Earth's atmosphere.